you, it's not like the modern martial arts where a student starts to train for, you know, personal development or to get give their belt rank or something like that. And it's not like a karate kata that they're familiar with. So the
hold on, hold on.
I
want to get them to at least show like a pattern before I stop recording.
So what we're gonna do is go step by step. So the first thing is, they start to face off against each other, and this is like when everything starts to really happen. She's sussing him out. He's sussing her out. He's taking a kumai, she's taking a kumai. This is a combative posture. He's raising his sword, and he's gonna yell at her. And he's gonna try to intimidate her, but it is not gonna work because I know Sasha. She sees a wrist that she can cut up against. And so she's going to do that. He sees that coming, and he's gonna cut down against it. He's not trying to smack the weapon away. He's just trying to cut down straight through it and deflect her cut. Okay, so that didn't work. He's gonna raise again. He sees her head. She doesn't want to get her head hit, so she turns off to the side and then receives his cut with her weapon. So Fred's going to see a tasty target with her foot. Again, she doesn't have to dance out of the way or get fancy. All she has to do is step back to the side and simply place the weapon where her leg was. And then he's going to go for her head again. She simply drops out of the way and swings the weapon up and cuts him up underneath the belly bar. Fred wants to have the last word though. So at the finish of the kata, he's going to make an aggressive movement right toward her face and say, yeah, you won this time, but next time. So that's what's going on with that kata. I'm not going to explain, there are four more katas.
Hold on. It's almost done.
But try to look for elements of the things that I just talked about in each of those as individuals.